remain still, save for a blazing shadow poised to strike. Kul's insights fell like quicksand, sinking in terror at the sight. The shape lunged, metal crashed, and Adirin's light went out. Quill's beating heart drew Sarfog's attention. It was a monster of such harrowing enormity that survival seemed impossible. But then, the reader illuminated a break in the stone. Quill dove, the opening just big enough, and narrowly escaped the snap of Sarfog's fiery jaw. Instinct fueled Quill's desperate flee. The littered limbs of those before her served as haunting reminders that this was where so many before her met their end. Her adrenaline waned. Trembling and anchored by a heavy heart, she slowed, stumbled, and crumpled to the cold ground. Quill had never felt more small and helpless. It would take an army to defeat Sarfog. Then, she felt a gentle touch of warmth and mustered the strength to look up. The reader was still there, expressionless as always, but unwavering in their loyalty. Quill felt the depth of their connection. The strength that came with being twofold. They'd come so far. Together. My friend, I need your help. If we don't face Sarfog now, my uncle will die. And that monster won't stop until you and I are torn apart. Will you stay with me? And try. Quill searched the silent halls.
Uncle? Uncle!
She called, but only her echoes responded.
Really, you? You have to get out of here if Sarfog finds you.
Uncle, Sarfog is dead. His voice trembled as he spoke.
The glass, the reader, you've bonded. I wanted to keep you safe from all this. It is not a burden you can bear alone.
I'm not alone.
My Quill, twofold and strong.
He resigned. We're safe now, she assured him. Let's go home.
No, Quill. You've never been in more danger.
His voice faltered.
The Arcane do not end with Sarfog. The King's glass, hidden here in the castle. You must reclaim it.
Where? We're ready. Promising beginning, indeed. For so long, another has toiled to write an end for us all. But your bond with Quill grows strong. Your fates, yet still unwritten, are now entwined. And that gives us hope. Yes, your journey together is far from over. Rest now, dear reader. We'll begin again soon.
The dark wood falls before me, with broken bough and blackened leaf. I stand where trees meet with the sky, and in the stillness find you by. When all the paths are overgrown and evening falls with crimson glow, into the forest I will fly, and in its shadow